Welcome to the Good Hope Country Day School commencement for the class of 2020. All of your teachers, parents, family, and friends are proud of you for your many accomplishments, and we're delighted to celebrate with you, even if in this unusual format. On account of COVID-19, most of this year's graduation ceremony is being filmed ahead of time and will be published on Saturday, May 30th, our actual graduation day, at 10 a.m. The remainder of our ceremony, the part every graduate has been working on for the better part of the last 13 years, will be conducted in person with appropriate physical distancing on Saturday at 5 p.m. This has been a senior year you will never, ever forget. With around two-thirds of the school year occurring on campus as usual, culminating in a great mini-gusto week. But the last third of the year, you finished online, in Zoom conversations, and online lectures, made possible by those electronic devices your teachers and parents have so often nagged you about. You are indeed from a new era, the electronic era. And you will be ready for whatever the challenges and changes your generation and your lifetime will bring. GHCDS will miss you all for your character, your tenacity, your scholarship, and your resilience. We couldn't be prouder of you. And now for the rest of our ceremony.
Today we join our hearts in prayer to give our trust in a higher power over the 2020 graduating class of Good Hope Country Day School. Thank you, God, for leading us in our learning, keeping us safe as we studied throughout the years, and watching us over in our final hours as high school seniors. God, please allow us the ability to recognize our detours, overcome our challenges, and make us resilient during crises beyond 2020. Oh God, I pray that you bless us with the miracles that have no other way of reaching us. May you continue your investment in us, allow us the understanding that each of us is unique and brimming with potential. This will allow us to use our skills and talents to achieve the greatest success. God, may you provide us the courage and grace to make wise choices and be authentic to ourselves and our commitments. This will allow us to be reassured in the support of those who love us. God, allow us to feel anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of our most vulnerable, so that you will work for justice, equality, and peace, especially during the COVID-19 pandemic and the unrest in the world. God, please continue to bless us with belief and hope so we can and will make a difference in the world. With your blessing, we will do things that others tell us we cannot do. May today be your memory that burns bright as we embark on life's great adventures. God will provide his powerful protection over us as we go to different places and embark on life's new journey. We ask that you watch over every step we take and keep our footsteps secure. God, may our class of 2020 feel proud of our special day and enjoy sharing all of our achievements with our family and friends. And most of all, may our integrity be a gift to the world, as may the Spirit of God be with us all, always.
Our next speaker is someone I met 14 years ago backstage at a Caribbean dance show. One second we were complete strangers sitting next to each other, and the next we had bonded over a mutual appreciation for fruit snacks, and the rest is history. I am lucky enough to have grown up with Naima Gibbs, to have shared countless memories with her, to have had dance-offs at summer camp to the song Super Bass by Nicki Minaj, and to have worked alongside her throughout high school. I've seen her mature into the diligent, well-rounded, hard-working student she is today. She is involved in many campus clubs and other off-campus extracurricular activities. In fact, she was the student council president for the 2019-2020 school year, as well as vice president of our class. She is a leader who takes initiative and is always there for any classmate, teacher, or friend who needs her. I've seen her work tirelessly for our class and always goes above and beyond to assist our faculty in any way possible. Simply put, Nyama goes the extra mile. She has been a person who anyone can go to for advice, for help setting up a school event, and when needed, she is someone you can count on for a laugh. Without further ado, it is my honor and pleasure to introduce Nyama Gibbs.
Graduates, now the joy begins, now the work begins. The years of preparation, of tedious study, and exciting learning at least begin to make sense. The jumble of words and the tangle of small and great thoughts begin to take order. And this morning, you can see a small portion, an infinitesimal portion, of the map of your future. You have still had to develop an outstanding courage to invent this moment, for you have invented it. Of all your attributes, your youth, your beauty, your wit, your kindness, your money, courage is indeed your greatest achievement. It is the greatest of all virtues, for without courage, you cannot practice any other virtue with consistency. And now that you have shown that you are capable of manufacturing that important and wondrous virtue, you must be asking yourselves what you will do with it. Be assured that that question is in the minds of your parents, of your instructors, of people whose names you will never know, of a group of students who will sit in those very seats next year. That is the question. There's an African statement which is, "The trouble of a thief is not how to steal the bugle, but where to blow it." Since you have worked this hard, since you have been greatly blessed, since you are here, you have developed a marvelous level of courage. And the question then which you must ask yourself, I think, is will you really do the job which is to be done? Make this country more than it is today, more than what James Baldwin called these yet to be United States. It takes a phenomenal amount of courage. For all this world, your world, my world, there are conflicts, brutalities, humiliations, terrors, murders around this world. You can almost take any Rand McNally map and close your eyes and just point, and you will find there are injustices. But in your country, particularly in your country, young people, you have, as the old folks say, your work cut out for you. Be assured of it. Sexism, racism, ageism, every vulgarity against the human spirit is on the rise, and this is what you have inherited. However, on the other hand, you have first is your courage. You may lean against it. It will hold you up. You have that. And the joy of achievement, the ecstasy of achievement, it enlightens and lightens at the same time. It is a marvelous thing. Today your joy begins. Today your work begins. You are phenomenal. I believe that we are phenomenal. I know us to be. It is upon you to increase your virtue, the virtue of courage. It is upon you. You will be challenged mightily and you will fall many times. It is upon you to increase your virtue, the virtue of courage. It is upon you. You will be challenged mightily and you will fall many times. But it is important to remember that it may be necessary to encounter defeat. I don't know, but I do know that a diamond, one of the most precious elements in this planet, certainly, in many ways the hardest, is the result of extreme pressure and time. Under less pressure, it's crystal. Less pressure than that, it's coal. Less than that, it's fossilized leaves and just plain dirt. You must encounter, confront life. Life loves the liver of it. It is for you to increase your virtues. There is that in the human spirit which you will not be gunned down even by death. There is no person here who is over 1 year old that hasn't slept with fear or pain or loss or grief or terror. And yet we have arisen and have made whatever absolutions we were able to or choose to, dressed and said to other human beings, "Good morning, how are you? Fine, thanks." Therein lies our chance toward noblest, toward nobility, but noblest. The best of human being is an ability to overcome. Thank you.
I have the honor of presenting two incredible salutatorians for the class of 2020. The first student truly loves to learn. She's passionate about world affairs, current events, and is an active member of the Junior Statesman, PRISM, TRIAM, and Student Council. She was described by her teachers and classmates as having an energy and enthusiasm that is inspiring and contagious, and being one of our best in science and theater. She's a talented actress and songwriter and has performed in key roles for all 4 years of high school. She's also an avid reader, an eloquent writer, and a seeker of truth. While attending a summer program at the School of New York Times, she was inspired and eager to start a school newspaper, the Panther Post, which ignited her passion for journalism. She did not, however, let this pandemic minimize this important work, but instead requested and received approval to join a professional online school newspaper. She stated that having an outlet and a way to foster community and create connections while being physically distant from one another would greatly help boost morale during these tough times. With plans on attending the University of Virginia, I'm proud to present one of our salutatorians for the class of 2020, Carolyn Grimm.
Good afternoon and welcome to my fellow graduates, to faculty and staff, and to family and friends. I'd like to start this speech by saying that I've always found the concept of valedictorian and salutatorian speeches a little odd. Being good at school and getting good grades certainly takes hard work and determination, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you have any more wisdom than anybody else. I know this because some of the most important lessons I've learned weren't things I learned in a classroom. Don't get me wrong. High school has given me so much knowledge that's shaped the way I see the world. AP US History strengthened my convictions. Calculus taught me that sometimes the answer is simpler than you think. English taught me that some of the so-called simplest questions are the ones with no right answer at all, and chemistry taught me that magic is real, but most people just call it science. And though these are all valuable lessons, they're not necessarily the biggest ones I've learned in the past 4 years. One of the most important things I've learned is that, regardless of the big picture situation, there is always joy to be found in the microscopic moments. That while life is defined mostly in big, momentous occasions, it's also defined in little wonders, in the small details that fall between the cracks of our everyday lives. I think that lesson is particularly applicable in our current situation. Today, of course, marks one of the biggest milestones any person will achieve in their life, graduating high school. But for the class of 2020, that milestone is compounded by a global pandemic. So much is changing for us right now, and that kind of change can be really overwhelming. Focusing on the positives in such turbulent times is difficult, but it's both possible and necessary. Lately, I've been thinking a lot about how, 20 years from now, I will look back on my time at GHCDS as the good old days. Surely I will remember the big stuff. Maria, the pandemic, prom, graduation. But what I hope I'll remember are the small, ordinary details. Eating oranges with my teammates at cross-country meets. Singing backstage during Mamma Mia, laughing so hard in senior English that my stomach hurt, driving with all the windows down after school with my closest friends in the back seat. The fact of the matter is that a lot of things in life are uncontrollable. There will be storms you can't avoid and viruses you can't control. But the way you react in those situations is entirely your choice. You can choose to let the biggest and scariest moments define you, or you can choose to define yourself by life's smaller day-to-day joys. Maybe some people are okay wallowing in cynicism and believing that your only option is to let life happen to you, but I'd rather stare at the sunset with friends old and new and realize that the world is too big and too beautiful to believe that being alive is anything less than awe-inspiring. This class helped me realize this fact. We've gone through a lot together. Irma, Maria, coronavirus, any class with Mr. Summerhays, because we all know they're not easy. But we made it through. These huge, uncontrollable, life-altering events weren't enough to break us. We got through it together, and it didn't take a miracle or an army. It just took us supporting each other and focusing on what good does exist in the world, even if it's not the kind of goodness that makes headlines. We are so full of strength, and I am so inspired by the unbreakable bonds we formed together. So thank you. Thank you to this wonderful class of 2020 for inspiring me every day in ways big and small. And thank you to all of the faculty, staff, friends, family, and mentors who helped us to get to where we stand today. I hope all of my fellow graduates take a moment today to reflect back on not only the most memorable parts of your high school careers, but also on the smaller details. And I hope it helps you realize that despite the craziness and chaos, we made it through. That's how I know that regardless of where we end up, we're all gonna be just fine. In fact, we'll thrive. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Thank you.
Our other salutatorian for the class of 2020 is a passionate, dependable, and quiet class leader. She always gives generously of her talents with no expectation of praise. This student is also a dedicated learner and has excelled in both Spanish and French for all 4 years of high school, while also exhibiting a great love for German. She somehow achieved the highest rank in chemistry while taking additional math and science courses, being an active member in the National Art Honor Society and Melanin Magic, and a writer for the student newspaper, Panther Post. She's described by her classmates and teachers as a great artist, excellent baker, talented photographer and videographer, determined runner, an exceptional student with an excellent work ethic. She describes herself as an extreme football and cycling fan who has conquered 3 Ionic Tour de France mountains. She exhibited great wisdom in her senior thesis as she described cycling as being able to, in her words, bring us back together, reconnect us, and remind us that we're all people just trying to get from A to B. With plans to major in environmental science at the University of the California of Los Angeles, I'm proud to present our salutatorian for the class of 2020, Miko Dizon-Buman.
Welcome again, friends, family, faculty, Headmaster Mr. Bug, Dean of the Upper School, Ms. Gray, and of course, the class of 2020. Thank you all for joining us and celebrating our graduation. I know this isn't how we pictured it to go. There are a lot more masks and a lot fewer people. I'm Miko Dizon-Buman, the salutatorian, along with my friend Carolyn Grimm. May I just quickly acknowledge this trio of valedictorian and salutatorians. Just 4 years ago, Kelsey, Carolyn, and I were giving our Val and Sal speeches at 8th grade celebration. I'm so proud of us for continuing to work hard throughout high school, and I know we're all grateful for this opportunity to speak at our celebration. Graduating classes all over the world are extremely strong for pushing through these times, but I'm especially proud of our class of 2020. Throughout the years, we've experienced the merging of 2 schools, Category 5 hurricanes, the non-existence of WAPA, and now a global pandemic. We went from preparing MREs in class to sleeping through Zoom meetings. That's what I call character development. But in all seriousness, we have faced countless struggles, whether individually or as a class. But as far as I'm concerned, we will continue to overcome every obstacle we meet. That's the funny thing about my class. Even when the odds are against us, we persevere and make things happen. Whether it be graduating during a pandemic or completing senior thesis at the very last minute, we always finish what we started. Now, I'm not going to dwell on the reality of our changing world. Rather, I'm going to highlight some of the positives of our high school experience. For one, we got to celebrate both orange and white team wins, and while there's no orange and white day this year, I think we can all agree that orange would have smoked you guys. Prom last year was also pretty cool, but we're not going to forget about our senior prom and our senior cruise, which we're going to have even if it's not until our 10-year high school reunion. Lastly, our beach day. When I was writing this speech, I realized that my last normal day before we all started social distancing was spent with you guys at Shoy's. We've only had a couple official beach days, but I know we are looking forward to organizing many more in the last semester. While that couldn't happen because of COVID-19, I'm so grateful for the time we had together and that I could spend my last day of normal life with my favorite people. I would like to thank my family. Thank you to my dad for taking me around the world and introducing me to so many of my interests. Thank you to my brother for always being more than enthusiastic to doing something fun with me. And lastly, thank you to my mom for being the reason I'm standing here today. I know she's really happy that I'm following her footsteps, as she also graduated salutatorian at Country Day School about 70 years ago. I'd also like to thank our advisors, Mr. Canning, Ms. Thatcher, and Ms. Wilson. I can't even begin to express how we will miss all of you. Not only have you supported us throughout the years, but you have tolerated us as well. My class can be challenging at times. Nevertheless, you always kept a lighthearted spirit when getting us back on track. To my own advisor, Ms. Wilson, I'm going to miss your comfy AC'd classroom, and I thank you for sharing your positivity and kindness with me and my classmates every day. Now I would like to thank all the parents and family members who have supported not just one, but all of us, and of course our teachers. Some of our teachers have supported and guided us since the beginning of middle school, and they've helped create us into the intelligent and unique individuals we are today. I have a few final words for my class. One, look after yourself. Life can be overwhelming, and there are times when we lose sense of what's important. I can only encourage you to never hold yourself back from pursuing your goals. Do what makes you happy, and try not to worry about what other people think of you. I know it's a lot easier said than done, but try to remind yourself as much as possible that what other people think of you is not your responsibility. Also, be kind to one another. The more love you give to others, the more love you will feel for yourself. And lastly, we all better stay in touch after and during college. I'm never forgetting any of you, so I hope you don't forget me either. I love you guys. Congratulations, class of 2020.
The honor of being named valedictorian of one's class is earned quite simply by having the highest GPA among your peers. At Good Hope Country Day School, the competition is stiff, and the path to this honor, a four-year commitment. A commitment not only to doing your absolute best, but to going beyond the requirements of a syllabus, by encouraging excellence in your classmates, by setting the example for others, and by committing to your teachers that you will challenge yourself in the opportunities that they will provide for you to succeed. Kelsey Bola has earned the distinction of valedictorian for the class of 2020, and we are honored and proud to bestow it upon her. Her relentless work ethic and high personal expectations set her apart as a student who not only wishes to get the grades, but one who wants to grow her knowledge, gain understanding, master content, and strive to answer all the questions she has. The self-discipline, conscientiousness, and maturity that she brings to her academic study ensures her grades. Her willingness to collaborate with her teachers and her peers ensures her personal success. Kelsey applies these same attributes to all aspects of her very busy life. A natural leader, Kelsey is president of her class, as well as the National Honor Society. As a member of Junior State of America, Kelsey took college courses in the summers. Her membership in every club but one in high school speaks to Kelsey's desire to always be engaged, to sample everything which is offered, to making the most of her high school years. A talented runner, Kelsey learned early how to manage her time for both her studies and her training. Despite her busy schedule, Kelsey makes time for friends and volunteering, and is a supportive, caring, and devoted sister and daughter. She is courageous in the face of adversity and maintains a lighthearted and funny disposition through good times and bad. Thank you for joining her class and the faculty and administration in congratulating Kelsey and her parents on her many accomplishments, on her decision to attend Harvard University in the fall, and in this esteemed honor tonight.
Good evening, Good Hope Country Day School Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, staff, family, friends, and graduates. I'm honored to stand here today to deliver this valedictory address, which, as you know, is literally a farewell address. This is the occasion when I, on behalf of the class of 2020, bid a fond farewell to the Good Hope Country Day School. This message is not mine alone, Rather, it is pieced together from the experiences of the class of 2020 over the years. But I only have a few minutes, so here it goes. First, I take this opportunity to thank some of the people who played a role in getting us to this point. To our parents, siblings, grandparents, extended family, and friends, thank you for your unconditional love and support, which has meant the world to us. To the board, administrators, faculty, and staff, you have all, in your own unique ways, pushed us to be better students and citizens. To the facilities staff, thank you for all you do, often in the shadows, and often without much recognition from students. To our coaches, thank you for your words of inspiration and quotes, often from questionable and unknown sources, even when the odds were against us, or quite frankly, when nothing short of a miracle would have brought us a win. No matter the outcome, good sportsmanship was always demanded. While there are more thank yous that I can possibly fit in this allotted time frame, I would be remiss if I didn't mention two individuals. Miss Wilson, you are one of the most selfless people I've ever known. You were always there for us, if not with a gourmet dish to serve 10 people, then with the right advice to help us through any hardships. Miss Thatcher, you've been so much more to us than a college counselor. You've been a source of constant encouragement and pushed us to go the extra mile. Thank you both for being a living embodiment of GHCDS teachings of kindness, compassion, and social responsibility. As I said previously, there are more people to whom we give thanks, and some of those expressions of gratitude will come by way of private conversations. As I turn to my classmates, I think of a quote by Helen Keller that has been on my refrigerator at home for I don't know how many years. But suffice it to say that it's been there for a long time and states that character cannot be developed in ease and quiet. Only through experience of trial and suffering can the soul be strengthened, ambition inspired, and success achieved. I see my class of 2020 that has faced many personal challenges as having immense character. We have all struggled in some way, and as life guarantees us, there will be challenges along the way. What matters is how we respond to those challenges. There were some major events we all struggled with, like the Category 5 hurricanes, Irma and Maria, the unprecedented COVID-19 pandemic, and the comparatively minor but incredibly impactful experience of running the GHCDS Snack Shack. Imagine all of us having to purchase food, cook, and serve in the Snack Shack to raise funds for class activities. Trust me when I say that if our friendship can survive the Snack Shack, it can survive just about anything. On a more serious note, the catastrophic hurricanes of 2017 impacted many families emotionally, financially, and academically. Some classmates moved away, and their lives have taken them in different directions sooner than we anticipated. Now, as I speak, we, like the rest of the world, are navigating our way through a pandemic. The coronavirus pandemic was a curveball none of us anticipated as we planned our senior year. But as unprecedented and as tragic as COVID-19 has been, it has also been a time for many of us to pause our hectic schedules, reflect on people and things that are important to us, empathize with those who've lost loved ones, and remind ourselves that we are truly VI strong. For this class, social distancing did not mean social isolation. We found new ways to communicate and stay connected. This year, we didn't have the in-person thrill of victory or the agony of defeat of orange, white, and blue day, but white team would have won anyway. There was no prom, end-of-year assemblies, or awards nights. However, like seniors before us, we had late nights, early mornings, days we wish would never end, and days we wish would end as quickly as possible. And we made it to graduation. Although it definitely isn't how we imagined it, if we think about it, this is probably the most class of 2020 way our graduation could have gone down. Testing out the first ever virtual graduation in GHCDS history with face coverings and a drone photograph motorcade. The class of 2020 was something else. We were the class that essentially suffered from senioritis for all 4 years of high school. The class that I'm sure kept Ms. Gray up at night, wondering what sorts of issues we'd burst into her office with next. And the class that endlessly, and I mean endlessly, debated almost every class decision we ever had to make. And yet, as I stand here, I'm absolutely certain that I wouldn't have traded the last 4 years I spent with each and every one of you for the world. I wish I could go into detail and share the immense impact each of you had on me and the rest of the class, but that would take much more time than I have. We did this together and will cherish our high school memories. Whether we will be able to attend college in a physical classroom setting in the fall is still mostly unknown, but sometime soon, we will no longer be together. In fact, after graduation, all of us may never be in the same place at the same time again. There will be some pretty significant changes ahead. We'll have to make our own decisions, make new friends, and actually check Instagram ourselves to find out how many followers a celebrity has instead of just asking Gabe. For the most part, we will be working on our own to adjust to our new surroundings. Now, I can't say that I know what the future will hold for us or give some profound advice about life, but I would like to leave you with some advice that I've found to be effective at motivating me when tasked with having to adjust to something new. Think of a reason bigger than yourself that motivates you to work hard. As we go off and face new challenges, sometimes self-doubt may creep in, telling us that maybe we aren't cut out for that particular thing, that we should quit. In times like that, remind yourself of that source of motivation, whether it is your family, our little island, or just anyone that believed in you. And when you find yourself struggling to roll with the punches, remind yourself that you are doing it for all of those that believe in you, and use that motivation to pick yourself up and keep trying. I'd like to end with one final note to the class of 2020. I love you all very much. Each of you has shaped my life in incredible ways. I cannot wait to see what we accomplish in the future. Congratulations to the class of 2020. We finally did it.
Voted on by her teachers in high school, the faculty award is bestowed upon the student to whom the faculty feels most connected to in the day-to-day and over the course of 4 years. Our senior class is filled with amazing students, and yet Carolyn rose to the top to earn this distinction for the class of 2020. Was it due to her strong commitment to her academics and to her thirst for knowledge? Perhaps it was her always cheerful grumpiness in the morning, or her sincere inquiries as to how we're doing, that reminds us of the care for others she always exhibited. Who can forget her many starlet portrayals on the stage throughout the high school years, which brought humor and joy to all? It could be memories of her croning along with her ukulele to a songgram on Valentine's Day that sealed the deal. Let us not forget her dedication to early morning track practice or her search for truth as a journalist and editor-in-chief of the Panther Post. A scholar, a thespian, an emphatic friend, an athlete, a Renaissance woman. All guessing aside, it is for these reasons and more that the faculty are pleased to present Ms. Carolyn Grimm with the Class of 2020 Faculty Award.
Congratulations, Class of 2020 graduates. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to share how proud we are of your accomplishment and our sincere gratitude for the entire GHCDS community that has made this day possible. It is my pleasure to present the annual GHCDS Trustee Award. This award recognizes the graduating senior who most exemplifies our mission, values, and philosophy. This year's recipient, as selected by the faculty, is a hard-working superstar that embodies our core values of scholarship, integrity, respect, and citizenship. As the Class of 2020 valedictorian, Kelsey Bola certainly has made scholarship a priority in her time at Good Hope Country Day School. At the same moment, Kelsey has excelled in other areas of her life, as described by upper school English teacher, Miss Wilson. Outside of the classroom, Kelsey is constantly busy and involved. If not involved at a Junior State of America or Student Council event, or a National Honor Society community service project, Kelsey can be found before school and after school training for track. She is a gifted athlete and trains with all her heart. Our mission at Good Hope Country Day School calls us to prepare every student with the tools to better their island and world. Kelsey truly embodies the goals of our mission and the best qualities of our community. Knowing the huge impact she has had on the GHCDS community brings us great confidence that she is well equipped to succeed in college and better the world. Kelsey, we will certainly keep a close eye for your future accomplishments. Please join me in congratulating this year's Trustee Award recipient, Kelsey Bola.
Members of the Class of 2020, families, friends, faculty, trustees, you may not be surprised to hear me open tonight with a poem. Here's one you may or may not know by Emily Dickinson. There is no frigate like a book to take us lands away, nor any coursers like a page of prancing poetry. This traverse may the poorest take without oppress of toll. How frugal is the chariot that bears the human soul. There is no frigate like a book to take us lands away, Emily Dickinson tells us. A book, a poem, a work of art can take us on a journey in our imagination. And in our own lives, we have the opportunity to lay down a path for our own journeys, to find our own way, and to make meaning for ourselves and our world. Where are you going? Where are you headed? What's a journey that has had an impact on you? Are questions we might ask. All the more relevant during this strange time in history in which we have been stuck in our homes, contained, or even claustrophobic, ready to leap beyond the contours of our dwellings and experience the world of college and whatever else this future may bring. One of the books I was fortunate enough to read to each of my three sons was Robert Louis Stevenson's Treasure Island. When I was a child myself, I loved that book and longed to live on an island, treasure or no treasure. Nearly a year ago, my family just up and did it, landing on this spectacularly special place, St. Croix, our small island just 28 miles long by 6 miles wide, 1,850 miles to the southeast of Vermont from which we moved. There is no frigate like a book to take us lands away, Dickinson said. For us, the book became the ship that took us lands away. In Robert Louis Stevenson's book, young Jim Hawkins leaves behind his mother and everything he knows and goes on a journey to an island far away. You may know the story. The one-legged pirate, Long John Silver, and his green parrot, Captain Flint, and, of course, the famous map. X marks the spot, leading to buried treasure. When I first read it as a child, Jim Hawkins' adventure was my own journey. I experienced the oceans and the decks and the sails of the ship from my own bedroom. Robert Louis Stevenson was sickly throughout his life and died at the young age of 44. As a boy, I thought that he dreamed up Treasure Island solely from the power of his imagination. But I learned later that Stevenson was a world traveler who took exotic journeys of his own, most notably buying a second-class passage on a steamship from his native Scotland to the United States, and later moving to the South Pacific, where he died in the Samoan Islands in 1894. Some of the characters of Treasure Island were based on people he met in his travels as he journeyed across the world following his passions. What more could one want out of life? You all will soon be setting sail on a new journey, whether metaphorically or in real life. When you think of your journey to come, you might think of an adventure to Europe, or a cruise to Cancun, or a train trip from Nova Scotia to Alaska. You might imagine a sailing trip in the South Pacific, or a hike along the Appalachian Trail, or a bicycle trek across America. You might consider your journey to be the path, your path, through life. The 15 years of preschool through 12th grade. The hard work you've done to earn your diploma, the one you will receive later this evening. The times in which you have lived, with Ovensa's closing and the coming together of friends and teachers from Good Hope School and Country Day School, the travails of Hurricane Maria, the challenges of COVID-19, and the future parts of your path in which you will move from GHCDS to college, and when you're ready to a fulfilling career, these are parts of your journey to come. Stevenson's story suggests that it all starts with the journeys of your imagination, where you can travel as far as you dare, from here to a treasure island of your mind, over deeper oceans than transverse the Puerto Rican trench. GHCDS's mission is to cultivate reflective, creative, and compassionate students who are critical thinkers prepared to excel in college and empowered to better their island and the world. As you reflect and create, you are taking your very own journey. As you give to others, you are making it possible for others to carry on their own journey. As you think critically and excel in college, you are sharpening your sword to reach the treasure, to meet your objectives, to better your island and the world. You are starting with Stevenson's journey of the imagination. You are starting like Emily Dickinson's frigate that takes you lands away, where you can travel as deep, as far, as wide as you wish. And through the years, you will shape your journey to go where you dare to go. Good luck, esteemed and resilient graduates, as you seek your own treasure and dare to put your imagination to work. Good luck.
On behalf of Nancy Thatcher and the Upper School faculty, we present the diplomas to the class of 2020. Stephen N. J. D. Bannis. Stephen is undecided as to where he will attend in the fall, but whichever college is lucky enough to have him will gain a young man who sets his sight high, challenging himself to be his best, whether on the court, the field, or in the classroom, and his smile will certainly bright up their campus. Kelsey Gabrielle Bowler. As you can see from all her color cords, Kelsey is involved in most aspects of high school, most impressively in her academics. Kelsey asks questions, shares ideas, and gets to work. She's a natural leader and supportive friend. We are proud to be sending the recipient of the Math Award, the Science Award, the Sydney Fleming Heart of the Panther Award, the Spirit Award, and the Trustee Award off to Harvard University. Lydia Majena Boguslawska. A dedicated and talented swimmer, Lydia is no stranger to self-discipline and rigor. She sets her sights high and does what it takes to reach them. Her senior thesis presentation on global warming demonstrated not only her passion for the topic, but also the academic skills she will take to Montclair State University next year. Enbiko Taran Boro. Enbiko is a maturing scholar, developing the ability and desire to go deeper into his learning. As an Eagle Scout, Enbiko embodies the attributes of such. He is trustworthy, compassionate, determined, and caring. A deep thinker with a great capacity for empathy. We'll be sending Enbiko off to the University of West Florida with a big bag of chocolate. Zachary Victor Bozzo. The youthful energy and joie de vivre of Zach's early high school years has given way to the engaged and curious senior before you today. The growth Zach has shown in the past year has been met with respect and joy from his teachers. Zachary will attend University of the Virgin Islands come August. Layla A. Celine Bradshaw. Underneath her quiet facade, Layla is a champion for truth and justice. On the surface, she's a loyal friend, a budding scholar, and a fashion statement ready to be made. Jefferson University awaits her in the fall. Douglas L. Capdeville. On the course, in the classroom, or in conversation, you will get the best of Dougie. Earning his Eagle Scout this year is no surprise. He is honest, sincere, persistent, and kind. Dougie gives his all to whatever task is at hand. He's a pleasure to all, and we will miss him as he heads to Syracuse University in the fall. Donovan J. Capdeville. Donnie is quiet and reflective, always considering the ideas of others and welcoming their points of view. Donnie earned his Eagle Scout this year, demonstrating the qualities sought after by the scouts and by our school. Smart and determined, he's eager to continue his scholarly pursuits at Syracuse University. Gabrielle J. Capdeville. Gabe will, must succeed. It is his mantra to do so, and we all believe he will, much as he successfully completed his Eagle Scout this year. Curious, funny, bright, and always searching for the next best thing, Gabe will pursue his future dreams at Syracuse University. Savannah Rose Capdeville. Savannah, too, will attend Syracuse University in the fall. Her high school career has been filled with deep engagement in the Junior Statesmen of America, as well as many other clubs, affording her opportunities in which to try out her leadership skills. Funny, kind, and smart, we will miss her bright presence on campus next year. Miko Isabel Dizan Buman. She climbs mountains, she cycles legs at the Tour de France, she bakes, she's an avid reader, she's a salutatorian. There are no boundaries to the interests that Miko pursues, including her study of French and Spanish, for which she's a recipient of the French and Spanish Language Awards. The University of California, Los Angeles, will be lucky to welcome her this fall. Dominic Alexis Lachey Elise. Dominic is a young woman of many talents, a thespian, a musician, a dancer, a scholar, and successful in all her pursuits. Dominique is a recipient of the Excellence in Music Award. We know she'll continue to her successes at Tandon School of Engineering at New York University this fall. Nyama K. Gibbs. Thank you.
A natural leader, a curious scholar, an accomplished dancer, and a champion for social justice, Nyama is poised to effect change in the world. Her sense of integrity, her pursuit of knowledge, and her generosity of spirit will serve her well at Howard University. Gabriela B. Gomez. How wonderful when Gabby returned to our school for her senior year. Her kindness, commitment to her education, and confidence in her future, combined with her easygoing and funny personality, have greatly enhanced the class this year. Gabby will attend the University of the Virgin Islands next year. Carolyn Elaine Grimm. Carolyn makes all aspects of her life seem easy. As an actress, athlete, musician, scholar, salutatorian, journalist, not one to want to choose, Carolyn chooses all. The recipient of the Theatre Award, the Humanities Award, the French Language Award, and the Faculty Award, we hope her new friends and professors at the University of Virginia can keep up with Carolyn next year. Augustus Wells Johnson. How lucky we were when Gus arrived on campus 3 years ago, immediately integrating into the class and our hearts. Possessing a curious intellect and a delightful sense of humor, Gus is an accomplished musician with an encyclopedic knowledge of most sports. We'll miss Gus as he heads to Temple University next year. Quincy Miles King. Quiet, quick-witted, and a deep thinker, curious and naturally intelligent, Quincy possesses a maturity and drive, both in the class and on the court, that will serve him well at Howard University, where he can unlock his incredible and untapped potential. Lucy Rose Klempen. Lucy always does her best. As a student, she's dedicated, intelligent, and curious. As a young woman, she's kind, funny, and responsible. As a sailor, she's competitive and passionate. Lucy will take her natural gifts and impressive athletic pursuit to the College of Charleston in the fall. Natalia Jean Capers. Natty is a free spirit whose desire to pursue her dreams of becoming an Olympic swimmer took her to Spain for her senior year. A bright and passionate student, Natty will attend Bryant University, where she will continue her competitive swimming. Sean Nelthrop Lowe. Always respectful, kind, and thoughtful, Sean is a pleasure to share company with. His growth throughout high school has resulted in a mature and self-confident young man who will begin his journey with the United States Coast Guard after graduation. We wish him well. Andre S. M. McIntosh. Andre is his own man. His sense of integrity and his search for knowledge beyond the surface are rare in young men of his age. He possesses a deep respect for others and for ideas. He is curious, intelligent, and driven. All qualities that will serve him well wherever he goes to attend college next year. Joseph N. Roth. The world will betray its campus, naturally bright and interested in experiential learning. Trey shined in his senior thesis presentation, demonstrating his passion for exploring solutions to the environmental challenges facing the future. We look forward to following his trajectory as we wish him well. Andrea Rose Olivia Carbajal Simpson. A gifted creative writer, Rose's college essay was unique and superb, earning her admission to the Susquehanna University Creative Writing Program in the fall, where we imagine she will blow up their writing program with her original and exemplary work. Arielle K. Sutherland. In class, Arielle is organized and thoughtful in her approach and is a sought-after collaborator. She's generous, responsible, and honest. Her sense of humor is bright and her smile will light up the room. We wish her well as she pursues her education at the University of the Virgin Islands. Larissa D. Sweeney. Larissa possesses a secure sense of self, a quiet confidence, and a fine sense of humor. A natural problem solver, she perseveres in her quest for knowledge and is happy to share her knowledge with others. Imaginative, creative, with an eye on solving environmental problems, Larissa will attend Loyola University, Maryland. Kimberly A. Thompson. Kimberly's natural intelligence and deep sense of self-awareness, along with her sharp wit and curious nature, not to mention her thoughtful opinions, which she's always eager to share, combine to make her a most enjoyable classmate. We'll miss Kimberly as she makes her way to Austin College next fall. Carlos Jose Van Gerp Castillo. Charismatic with a fine sense of humor, Carlos is confident and self-assured. He enjoys conversation with all students and faculty, eagerly sharing his opinions while respectfully listening to others. A dedicated athlete and budding scholar, Carlos will attend Hillsborough Community College. Kieran Hensley Walter Sundaram. Kieran is a self-made man. When he has an interest, he pursues it until he achieves mastery of a concept or completion of a project. Whether creating and producing music or YouTube videos or designing and building a solar recharging station for post-hurricane use in the territory for his Eagle project, Kieran can do it. He's intelligent, curious, respectful, and a collaborator. Savannah College of Art and Design will be lucky to have him. Sasha K. Wesley. Gracious, kind, and mature. Sasha possesses integrity and honesty, which have guided her throughout high school. Her natural intelligence and the pursuit of knowledge are evident in her group work and her conversations. She demonstrates empathy and generosity to all, and brings a delightful and warm sense of humor and joy to the class. We wish her all the best at the University of the Virgin Islands.
Good morning. Thank you all, our teachers, parents, friends, and family, for supporting us through this journey. Our time at Good Hope Country Day School is complete. Our honors have been bestowed, and the speeches have concluded. Later today, we will complete the celebration of our achievement, but our true journey will soon begin. As we close this ceremony and reflect on our unprecedented journey, I wish to leave you with God's message in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 12. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly and loving Father, thank you for guiding us through this challenging journey. Thank you for our family and school community. Despite friends' loss, personal pain, natural disasters, and a world pandemic, your love and mercy have kept us strong and guided our path. We know you have great, unforeseen plans for us, and the challenges we have endured have taught us patience and made us stronger. God Almighty, we give reverence to you today and ask for your continued blessings, clear vision, and unending love. God, grant us serenity to accept the things we cannot change, courage to change the things we can, and wisdom to know the difference. Restore our hope, patience, and constant faith in your plan. Hear our prayer as we untie our voices and we all say, Amen.
Buenos días. Gracias a todos, nuestros maestros, padres, amigos y familia, por apoyarnos a través de este camino. Nuestro tiempo en Good Hope Country Day School ha terminado. Nuestros honores han sido otorgados y los discursos han concluido. Más tarde, completaremos la celebración de nuestro logro, pero nuestro verdadero camino pronto comenzará. Mientras concluimos esta ceremonia y reflexionamos acerca de nuestro camino sin precedentes, deseo dejarlos con el mensaje de Dios en el libro de los Romanos, capítulo 12, verso 12. Regocíjate en la esperanza. Sé paciente. Sé constante en la oración. Oremos. Padre celestial y amoroso, gracias por guiarnos a través de este desafiante viaje. Gracias por nuestra familia y comunidad escolar. Porque a pesar de los amigos perdidos, la pena personal, los desastres naturales y una pandemia global, tu amor y compasión nos han mantenido fuertes y ha guiado nuestro camino. Sabemos que tienes grandes planes para nosotros y que los desafíos que hemos soportado nos han enseñado a tener paciencia y a ser más fuertes. Dios omnipotente, nosotros te damos reverencia hoy y te pedimos que nos sigas otorgando una visión clara y tu amor infinito. Concédenos la serenidad para aceptar las cosas que no podemos cambiar, el valor para cambiar las cosas que podemos y la sabiduría para saber la diferencia. Restaura nuestra esperanza, paciencia y fe constante en tu plan. Escucha nuestras oraciones, Señor, mientras unimos nuestras voces. Y decimos, Amen.
Graduates of the class of 2020 of Good Hope Country Day School, the Board of Trustees, the faculty and administration of our school are so proud of you, and we are so proud that you are now alumni.
come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand, close your eyes. With you right here, I'm a rocketeer. Let's fly, fly. Up, up, here we go, go. Up, up, here we go, go. Let's fly, fly, fly. Up, up, here we go, go. Where we stop, nobody knows, yeah. No. Where we going, we don't need roads. And where we stop, nobody knows. No. To the stars if you really want it. Got a jetpack with your name on it. Above the clouds in the atmosphere. Just say the words and we out of here. Hold my hand if you're feeling scared. We're flying up, up, out of here.
Here we go. Chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kick. Girl, you always on my mind, got my head up in the sky. And I'm never looking down, feeling priceless. Yeah, where we at, only few have known. We're on some next level, Super Mario. I hope this works out, cardio. Till then, let's fly, Geronimo. Here we go.
But I ain't never seen a face like yours. You made me feel like I could touch the planets. You want the moon, girl, watch me grab it. See, I ain't never seen a star this close. You got me stuck by the way you glow. I'm like, oh, 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 oh. I'm like, oh, 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 oh.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Come with me. There's a way.
If you really want it, got a jetpack with your name on it. Above the clouds in the atmosphere, just say the words and we out of here. Hold my hand if you're feeling scared. We're flying up, up, out of here.
Here we go. like a G6. Chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kicked. Girl, you always on my mind, got my head up in the sky, and I'm never looking down, feeling priceless. Yeah, where we at, only few have known. We're on some next level, Super Mario. I hope this works out, cardio. Till then, let's fly, Geronimo.
Here we go.
But I ain't never seen a face like yours. You made me feel like I could touch the planets. You want the moon, girl, watch me grab it. See, I ain't never seen a star this close. You got me stuck by the way you glow. I'm like, oh, 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 oh. I'm like, oh, 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 oh.
Here we go.